future technology. Boy, there are a number of future vectors going off like this. They're all sort of possible. So some of them could be terrific and some of them could be a mess.
Do you think it's going to be terrific or do you think it's going to be a mess?
Well, my hope and push for years and years is the terrific end. But there are a lot of things about prevailing paradigms that affect the choice of this path. And so, like one of them is saying, oh, things have to be easy to learn and easy to use. See, so you look at what kinds of artifacts that we employ today would be considered easy to learn and use by the people at the time they were first introduced. Like an automobile, driving an automobile in traffic, and realize the skill it takes, the skills that people don't appreciate how much they've evolved.
So if technology shoots off on that good vector, what sort of things can we expect to see?
Well, the one thing I feel is more critical than any other thing I can hand is the capability collectively for people to come to an understanding, the best understanding possible, of complex dynamic systems that are critical. And otherwise, it's like humanity is in some vehicle that's lumbering along and it's being steered by some kind of governing practices, something like that, where it goes. But the vision isn't very good and the steering is very, very clumsy. So what's likely to happen is being propelled faster and faster by changing things, accelerating technologies, so the probability of crashing is just going up and up. And you know, if human civilization crashes, make New Orleans thing seem like a...
What do we need to be afraid of? What do we need to watch out for?
Well, the watch out for are not looking to say what kind of capabilities could we really achieve. And some of it is steered by many factors that aren't the ones of saying how much capability could we really achieve? How do we go about exploring and going after that capability? And it's not going to be done effectively by industry's approach of what new gadgets will sell better. That's evolving, but very, very slowly. Develop here to look at different symbolic portrayals of knowledge. Kind, not the static kind that we're used to on a page, but a new kind that the computer can show us. Why aren't we going after that? You know, saying, hey, our machine here is capable of who knows how much more. Looking at something, aha, yes, yes. As you realize, you look at a page and you see a flow of characters. No, to you, it's a flow of words. Really, it's a flow of meaning. That machinery in your head, call it perceptual machinery, does that for you automatically because it's been conditioned. So it wasn't born to do that. It was born to be able to do that. So anyway, I strongly believe that books are going to become obsolete when we really learn how we can generate books.
What are books going to be replaced by?
Computer screens, and by stimuli you can get glasses, stimuli all over, and stimuli that are meant to portray concepts symbolically by symbols that we realize. Anyway.
Thank you so much for your time.